singers. Today, we are going to begin our program by rewinding a medley of TV classic theme songs. Most of us are familiar with some of these TV shows from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. How many of these 8 classics do you remember?
Saturday, what a day, rockin' all week with
Davis in 1980 on his LP of the same name. Today, we feature Tony Sekulin singing this popular hit. You decide. Have we cast him correctly?
Nope.
Voices. Today, we welcome Myna Cree, also with the voice of an angel, to perform this legendary Seekers number.
High above. This will be our last goodbye. Though the continent is over, I will love you till I die. Though the continent is over, I will love you till I die.
The next number is a song by the Swedish band ABBA. It was recorded and released in 1979 and was highlighted in the original Mamma Mia movie of 2008. 40 years later, Marty Zukulin, Pat Meehan-Shields, and Shirley Campbell will entertain us with their version of the song. Today, the Village Singers will perform a medley of some of their popular songs.
Wake up, little Susie. Susie, we have blue Susie.
the New Kingston Trio. John Denver released it on his Back Home Again album in 1974. It is upbeat, funny, and irresistibly singable. Hopefully, it will recall some childhood memories from your past. Signature. I imagine a good many of you have crooned along countless times upon hearing this unforgettable number. Please feel free to join in the final chorus today as Alan Dermody, Graham Dunnett, and the Village Singers perform Piano Man.
Oh, Now John at the bar is a friend of mine. He gets me my drinks for free, and he's quick with a joke, ought to light up your smoke, but there's no place that he'd rather be. It's a pretty good crowd for a Saturday, and the manager gives me a smile, 'cause he's always to me they'll be coming to see, to prevent a bad life for a while.
drops of breeze. Then every toss you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see. Following these numbers, please remain in your seats for our door prize draws and share the wealth.
Okay, everybody, just before intermission, what about those Raptors?
Thank you.
Bikini is our version of Brian Hyland's Itsy Bitsy Teeny Weeny Yellow Polka Dot Bikini that he wrote in June 1960. It became a number one hit in the Billboard charts. It's hard to remember now, but at the time, the bikini was considered a bit risque and not commonly worn. Hyland's song contributed to the increasing sale of the bikini, and many beach movies followed and built on this. You will undoubtedly recognize the surprise bikini model. Please welcome Joan Hume, stylishly rocking this attire. The brilliant Brian Wilson led them to many top hits as their composer, arranger, and producer. A version of the group still tours. Today we present a short medley of the Beach Boys songs, and we are happy to have Graham and Derm starting it off with On the Sloop John B.
Let me go home, I wanna go home.
stone. Why don't you leave me alone? When I feel so broken, I wanna go home. Hushed up the Japanese,
with his new girlfriend. Her name is Hiawatha.
and she had a safety pin right through her eyebrow. Now, I didn't know your eyebrow could fall off. But anyways, neither one of them are the smartest people, you know. Like, I blame his dad for him because he was always saying, "Don't get smart." And he didn't. So anyway, the reason they came over to help me on my computer because I was trying to get into a new website and it said, put in a password of 8 characters. So I put Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. But I couldn't get in. So then Hiawatha said to me, "Are you on Facebook?" And I said, "No, I'm on Fosamax." Honestly, kids, they make you go from acid rock to acid reflux. I'm telling you. So anyway, since I saw you guys last, my Bert and me, we had another anniversary. Yeah. Do you know I've been married so long that my oldest daughter's my age? So Bert said to me, "What would you like to do to celebrate the anniversary?" So I said, "Let's run upstairs and make love." And he said, "Make up your mind, I can't do both." So then I said, "I'd like to see 50 Shades of Grey." So he took a photograph of my hair. So I had to go to the doctor the other day for my annual physical. And the doctor said, "Now that you're really getting up there in age, I absolutely want you to put a bar in your shower." So I did, and it's got rum and vodka and plastic glasses. So the nurse said to me, "Well, come with me and I'll take your particulars." So she said to me, "Hey, how tall are you?" So I said, "I'm 5'4". So she measured me and I was 5'2". So then she said, "How much do you weigh?" I said, 135 pounds. So she weighed me and I weighed 180. So then she took my blood pressure and she said, "My, my, your blood pressure is awfully high." And I said, "Well, of course it is. When I come in here, I was tall and slim and now I'm short and fat." So she was telling me about this fella that the doctor was seeing. He was a retired army vet. So anyways, the doctor said to him, "So how long is it since you had sex?" So the vet thought for a minute and he said, 1975. So the doctor said, "Whoa, that's a long time." And he said, "Not really, doc. It's only 2150 right now." So I got to thinking about, after going to the doctor, about going through the change of life. Now, when you go through puberty, they tell you that you're going to become a woman. But when you go through the change of life, they don't tell you what you're becoming. I think I'm becoming my father. So anyway, I was talking to this friend of mine the other day, and her son, he's a policeman down in the United States. So he was out on patrol the other day, and he saw this car on the highway doing real slow, and he thought, "Oh, they're going to cause an accident." So he pulled them over, and there was 4 old ladies inside. So the one that was driving, she said to him, "Officer, I don't know why you pulled us over. I was not speeding. I was doing 22 miles an hour, just like the sign says." So the policeman looked at the sign and looked at her and said, "Ma'am, that's not the speed limit. That's the route number." So she said, "Oh." So he said, "It's 50 miles an hour here. But before I let you go, these ladies with you, are they all right? They're pale as ghosts and they don't look well at all." And she said, "Oh, officer, they'll be fine in a few minutes. We just got off Route 153. So one of my neighbors was telling me the other day, he went to visit his daughter and her family. They got 3 little boys and they're so cute. So he was downstairs and having a coffee, looking at his newspaper, and one of the little guys came in and he said, "Grandpa, can you make it sound like a frog?"
And he said, not now, honey. I'm just read my paper. You go play, and I'll play with you later. So off he went. So then a few minutes later, the next little boy came in, and he says, Grandpa, would you make a noise like a frog? And he said, no, I haven't finished my coffee yet. Now give Grandpa some space here. You go play. So off he went. So a few minutes later, third little boy comes in and says, Grandpa, please, please make a noise like a frog. So he put down his paper and he said, okay, what's all this nonsense about me making a noise like a frog? So the one little guy said, well, you see, Grandpa, Mom said, when you croak, we're going to Disneyland. Then I was talking to another neighbor, woman, and she was going to see her son and his family. These kids are older, teenagers. So she was sitting downstairs on the Chesterfield this one morning, and her teenage daughter comes down the stairs. She's got this see-through top on, completely see-through, nothing underneath. Well, my friend said to her, granddaughter, you better go upstairs and put some clothes on. That's disgusting. You can't go out like that. And she said, Grandma, you got to get with the times. All the girls are wearing tops like this. We have to show off our rosebuds. So the next morning, granddaughter comes downstairs. Grandma's sitting on the Chesterfield, completely naked from the waist up. Oh, the granddaughter's absolutely stunned, and she goes, Grandma, put some clothes on, that's disgusting. My friends are coming over, you're gonna embarrass me. So grandmother said, granddaughter, you gotta get with the times. If you young girls can show off your rosebuds, I can show off my hanging baskets. Anyway, I think I have to go now. So I just want to leave you with this thought. It's not the years in your life that count. It's the life in your years. That's the important thing. And remember, be really, really nice to your kids because they may pick your nursing home. Bye.
Was The Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet, which began in 1952 and which starred the Nelson family. When Ricky Nelson was 16, they began showcasing his talent by having him sing in many of the episodes. Very shortly after, he went on to become one of rock and roll's earliest teenage idols. The Village Singers will now present a medley of some of his best-known hits.
Oh yeah.
singer-songwriter Kenny Loggins as a gift for his brother Danny when his first son was born in 1971. Canadian country pop singer Anne Murray recorded her own version in 1972, and it was nominated for a Grammy Award. Here is Margaret Penrice performing Danny's song.
People smile and tell me I'm the lucky one, though it's just begun. Think I'm gonna have a son. He will be like you and me, as free as a dove, conceived in love. Sun is gonna shine above, and even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with you, honey. Everything will bring a chain of love, and in the morning when I rise, bring a tear of joy to my eyes and tell me everything's gonna be alright. Find a guy who holds the world in a paper cup. Drink it up, love him and he'll bring you luck. And if you find he helps your mind, better take him home. You don't wanna live alone. Learn to know what love is on. And even though we ain't got money, I'm so in love with you, honey. Everything will bring a chain of love. And in the morning when I rise, bring a tear of joy to my eyes and tell me everything's gonna be alright.
Hit for the Carpenters in 1973. It was one of their 10 singles that sold over a million copies. Karen's voice inspired many singers that came after her, ranging from K.D. Lang to Madonna. Today we present our version of Top of the World, and we are happy to have Judy Davidson performing a solo in this well-known song. Named New World. It is about a young man who realized when his neighbor was moving away that he had never told her how he felt about her. There are now several versions of the song, one of which has become very popular at Rosedale dances. Today we sing a sanitized version of the song.
Be warned, be warned.
Yes, sanitized, featuring Jim Convery with assistance from Joan Hume, and invite you to join in the chorus with your usual enthusiasm. Listen carefully to where Alice relocated after moving away.
Sally called when she got the word. She said, I suppose you heard. Yeah, about Alice. Well, I rushed to the window and I looked outside. I could hardly believe my eyes as a big limousine drove slowly into Alice's drive.
Alice.
Dear Alice,
when you go to the movies at the end of the show, you have the credits that go on and on and on. We'll try not to make it go on and on, but my job is to do the credits. I'd like you all to hold your applause till the end, if there is any. And hopefully no senior moments. So first of all, I would like to thank our director, Brenda Blaber.
Hold the applause till the end.
Brenda was part of the group that selected the music. Brenda has provided the overview to the show. She has coordinated for us with the clubhouse and with the entertainment committee. Brenda, thank you. Hold the applause. Next, I would like to thank our MC, Sandra Lindsay. Sandra, please stand up. Sandra has been an integral part of this show, not only introducing all of the individual songs, but she also has helped with producing the scripts for us all for learning our songs. Sandra, very much. Thank you. Next, I turn to the other side of the stage to our musical ensemble, and we will start with our chief musician, our director of music, our pianist, and that is Ann Matheson. Ann has been an essential part of this show. Not only has she helped us to produce music, she has also put together all of the little intermissions and linkages so that we move from one song to the other. She has also faithfully turned out twice a week to all of our rehearsals, making sure that not only do we know our words, but also that we pronounce our D's and our T's at the end of the words. And thank you, and smile. Also in our musical ensemble, we have Ray Kingsmore on the drums. And Brian Hamer on the bass guitar. Brian has now moved down to Niagara on the Lake, but has kindly come back to perform with us. Thank you very much. And finally, in our musical ensemble, we have Graham Dunnett on the guitar. Graham, as you saw, not only plays the guitar, but Graham also sings. Next year, we hope to get him to dance as well. Next on the list is the grip and the gaffer and the best boy, and I have no clue who they are or what they do, so we'll forget about them. And we'll move on to our technical director, Alan Dermody, or Derm, standing in the back there. Derm is not only responsible for coordinating and setting up our lights and our sound, he also records every single one of our rehearsals and sends it out to us on YouTube so that we can see how bad we sound and hopefully how much we can get better. Graham is assisted by a number of people on the floor, starting with Adam Shield on the soundboard, and then a passel of Zakulins with Tony Jr. on the lights, Anthony III on the spotlight, and Sarah and a friend, Jordan Tammen, in the front row, encouraging us all to applaud and laugh. Finally, you like the sound of that word, I bet. Finally, I'd like to thank the Entertainment Committee and Leslie Tammen, who arranged for ticket sales, setting up the auditorium, the 50-50 draw, the nibblies that we're all going to get to as soon as I shut up. So I will now do that after thanking the Entertainment Committee, and we'll then pass it on to the MC.
Before the MC takes over, this humble fellow needs a thank you too, since he has been the director of all our stage people. And he keeps telling us where to go, and where to go, and how to get there, who to dance, and so on. So thank you very much.
Sometimes they like to tell me where to go.
Most of us cannot recall a time when music was not a part of our lives. Whether singing in a choir, jamming out to the radio in the car, or simply listening to music. music while studying. Music has had a huge impact on what we have grown up to be. Music is a universal language and can be enjoyed by people from all different countries and backgrounds. We hope for the past 2 hours, we have allowed you to spend time feeling the age you are inside as opposed to the age you see in the mirror. Thank you for spending the afternoon with us, and after the finale, please join us for refreshments in the North Lounge.
For now.